welcome back to the Tax Advisor and Biz Coach Success Podcast. The purpose of these episodes is to help entrepreneurs become more successful, avoid tax and other business headaches. Remember to tune in frequently as we will be sharing tips, secrets, and expert recommendations on how you can manage your finances, improve wealth, and grow your business. Please like, share, and subscribe. Here's your host, Liz Soria.
Hello, everyone. Again, this is Liz Soria, your host at the Tax Advisor Business Success Podcast. And as usual, you know, I love bringing you great guests into my shows. And one of the things I'm bringing in today is a phenomenal doctor. And I think there could have been no one else better to talk about this topic than her. So I will go ahead and do a really brief intro about her. Her name is Christina Carballo-Perman.
Correct.
Close, okay. And we're going to be discussing today. The topic is really interesting, even including the men out there. I want you to listen to this episode, okay? It's important for you to learn a little bit about us. We're going to talk about woman empowerment at work and also business, because it's how equally are we being treated even in this society that we live in. So no further ado, I want to introduce you. Doctor, thank you for making the time to be with us, because I know you're a full-time physician and you have a very, very busy schedule. And I really, you know, I'm very grateful for you making the time to be here with us. So welcome. And if you'd like to just kind of bring up a little bit more about your expertise, that way the audience know a little more about you, I appreciate that.
Sure. Hello, everybody. So I have been a neonatologist, which is a subspecialty pediatrician that takes care of sick infants in the intensive care nursery for over 30 years. And I practice out of Phoenix, Arizona. And I have seen my share of women inequities in my position. And so the books that I've written, and this latest one, The New Working Woman's Revolution with a little R for evolution and a revolution, really talks about a lot of the problems that women face at work, how we can overcome them through becoming empowered, what empowerment means, and some of the corporate situations that we need to look for as women to help us be valued as empowered women.
And, you know, one of the things that I to me, it was very appealing about your background was the fact that a lot of times we believe that as a woman, and again, I'm not trying to be here too feminist, but the truth is that, you know, there was a lot of big revolution changes along in the 50s and 60s. But for some reason, we have kind of fallen into a comfort zone, or we call it plateau, where it's like I sense as a professional female that we're not heading up. We're just like in a flat line. And I think this is important. Again, this is not to go against men, but men, it's good for them to listen and learn from us that unfortunately they have sisters, they have wives, they have other female friends, and how, you know, we perceive things from our own perspective as professional, you know, female. So if you don't mind, you know, sharing that a little bit and kind of covering Absolutely. That part, please.
Absolutely. So as you said, 50s, 60s brought a lot of change. Certainly the suffrage movement back very early on in the 1900s with the women's vote and such, and then women's lib in the 50s and mostly 60s really helped bring to light women coming into the working world. And I think because women were offered the ability to work outside the home more easily at that point, and that we have the vote, there has been a lull in comfortable of, okay, I can go, I can find a job. But in actuality, things aren't equal. Women continue to be paid about 30%, anywhere from 18 to 30% less than men in the same job, and that is when we take away maternity leave, etc., and we equalize, we still are getting paid lower amounts. And The problem is that we have no protection in the work environment against sexual slash verbal slash even physical harassment. And all of this is coming back to light. Obviously, the hashtag MeToo movement has really brought it back to light. But also, we've had a resurgence, thankfully, of the Equal Rights Amendment movement. And essentially, we're one state away from ratifying it into our Constitution as an amendment for equal rights. And that amendment would guarantee women across the board that pay is equal, and that any harassment of any type would be a criminal offense. And that protection is very important, and women don't seem to quite understand. I mean, I've talked to other women and they say, oh, you mean we don't have rights under the Constitution? No, we're the only developed country with a constitution like ours and the other developed countries that have no protection for women in the Constitution.
Interesting. That is very interesting. Yeah. Huh. So now with this movement that's going on, what do you
think? It's going across the country, and the movement is called Equal Means Equal. And the last state I think that did ratify, to get it ratified was, I want to say, Delaware. And there's one, you need 38 states out of the 50 to ratify an amendment into the Constitution. We're one state away. And there's a big push.
Really? That's phenomenal.
State away. And I'm hoping that this year is the year that we can finally be protected under the constitutional law.
That is incredible. I was not even aware.
Many people aren't. It's very true. And if all your listeners look into the equalmeansequal.org movement, you will have all the information. And there's great leaders in it that will help you understand what's going on in our country still.
Well, Doctor, thank you for sharing that. I think that is extremely important. And by all means, I always see this because I think this is about my second episode. There was another one about, you know, business and women, how they, you know, really become successful. And it's not to be offensive by any means, but I think it's important for men, like you said, to hear these kind of, you know, interviews and so on, because they learn. And like you said, they have sisters, they have spouses. And it's nice to hear from a different perspective, not coming directly from one of the females in your, you know, in your circle, just to say. And please support us, because this is not a female vote, right? This is not something.
No. Absolutely not. No, this is
help us, you know, become even, you know, more free. And I think it's about value. We're not competing here.
And not at all.
By all means. And I want to bring that up because, you know, as a professional, like say female like you are, doctor, I mean, you know, we've been successful in our careers, but, you know, we're not competing here against men, but men don't need to compete against us neither. But there has to be, you know, equal pay. I mean, it's not fair, and I consider it really completely unfair that, and I agree with you, I've seen it. I have experimented under my own skin, and I'm not embarrassed to bring this up right now, where, you know, my very first career, and I will share this really quickly, I don't mean to kind of jump in, I do this sometimes, by the way.
No, that's fine, that's good.
I like sharing, you know, my true part of my story, and I think that's important for my audience to understand that obviously I'm far and beyond from being perfect, and I have went through a lot of pros and cons in my life to be who I am now. This is part of who I am now, from all the good and the bad, right?
Right.
Combination. So, and I want to share this because I remember my very first career, I became a computer programmer. That was my very first career, not even crunching numbers. And believe it or not, my classmates, were 80% they were men. That was a very controlling, you know, type of industry.
Right.
And still is the IT tech that we call now, the computer science.
Right.
And here I am, you know, in my early, you know, 20s, graduating with the same knowledge than my classmates. But when I was ready to get a JOB, I was not even given half
Wow.
It was offered to my classmates. My right. classmates, men, male, gender, were trying to push me and get me into the companies that they have been hired for the same pay. And believe it or not, they couldn't accomplish that for me.
Wow. Incredible.
All because I was a female. Even two of them came back to me straight on my face and said, I'm so sorry.
Right.
Because I don't understand. They were mad. I don't understand how can they be discriminating you just because you're right. a female. You have the same knowledge that I do.
Right.
So right. I wanted to share this because it does happen, folks. It is a true, it's a reality. And sad to know that after all these years, it's still happening. So right. what can women do that you feel, Doctor, from your perspective, to really show a clear message, a way that we can bring up value, if there's a possibility there, or?
Right, there is. And again, aside from the ERA being passed, what I write in my books is how women can empower themselves within their positions. And that's a word that's being used a lot, like empower yourself and empower. What does it really mean? And empowerment is bringing a group of people the validation, acknowledgement, and respect that they require to be considered equal. So it's equality across the board. And in that, my book, I talk about the 11 attributes I believe women need to empower themselves. But aside from that, and even if they do acquire that, that's great. But if the company doesn't honor that equity, then yes. There's a problem. And so I talk about how women need to look for companies that have an internal corporate social responsibility, which people don't understand. There's an external corporate social responsibility and an internal. And the external is the message and the mission that companies send out for outsiders to see what their company is all about. But the internal one is what that company does to protect their own employees. And if that policy doesn't have pay equity and consequences for harassment at work, and then there's a problem. And those aren't the companies women should be seeking out to work in. Now, can you change that from the inside? Yes, but it's difficult. And that's where the empowerment comes. If you can demonstrate that you are a leader in your field, and equal to anyone else, not dependent on race, sex, culture, doesn't matter. You are who you are because of what you bring to the table. That's very important. So
that is a great point. And after all, we have the same brain.
Correct.
You know, please right. tell people.
Now we do use things differently. So when sociologists really demonstrate the difference between men and women and how they respond and act to the folks around them, the problem becomes that when women want to be leaders, they say, okay, I have to act like a man. And that's when women are called bitchy, bossy, aggressive, because they're taking the attributes that are more male-like instead of using their female attributes that are more communal, team building, have more compassion, empathy, and
more nurture, more
right, more nurturing. And so both of these types of work well together, and you can have a combination. Each person can have those male traits or feminine traits. So my point is not to become a little man to become a leader, because that's when you get into trouble.
True. And that's a great point. No, I'm glad that you kind of brought that up. And again, you know, it's not that I leave my opinion. I do see the difference. It still exists. There's no doubt about it. Not only in the workplace, but let's talk about even in the business partnership.
Absolutely.
I've seen it happen where sometimes you have a partnership where there might be two males and one female. All right. Right. And I'm talking about strictly folks in this case, not about, you know, personal relationship. We're talking
right.
about strictly
right.
business. And yeah. even with that, I see with my own eyes the difference of how they treat the female partner.
Right.
Up to the point that sometimes, the male partner makes more money and they have more saying of how things are going to be run in the company just because that's the way it is for them.
Right.
And it's wrong because they need to realize that equity is, to me, something that I agree with you. We need to have that very established and very clear that we have the same rights. And when I say about brain, I'm talking about the structure. Obviously, our brain is formed same way, but we think differently as females. And I do agree with you on that, by all means, doctor. But it's not like we have a smaller brain.
Right.
Why we've been criticized and why we cannot think very well as men. It's not.
Right. Well, the problem is there's so many characteristics attributed to women that it becomes it's very sexist. So you're hysterical, you're emotional, you know, including women who have fallen ill, even male physicians dismissing symptoms. That's why cardiovascular disease in women has been ignored for so many years, because their symptoms are slightly different than men with cardiac illness, and yet they were called hysterical, or it's your period, or, you know, you're overthinking it, or you have anxiety, and all of these symptoms that were actually truly pathophysiology and a problem were being dismissed. And it's a shame, you know, we are still relegated to, oh, she's at that time of her month, or she's just so hysterical, or she's just, you know, it's terrible. Yeah. It really is.
And yeah, we need to deal with that. That's a reality, right?
Yes.
You know, and we call it our, you know, period days and stuff like that. And it's true. It is very emotional, okay? But I mean, we still are able to take a grip. We still are in control.
Correct.
So the fact that we get point fingers to because, oh, you're in one of those days of the month.
Yeah, exactly.
You're acting that way, or you're seen in that way. Or, I'm sorry, are you having one of those days?
Right.
Two men, right? So I always kind of laugh at that. And but I will tell you something, doctor, that I have learned, you know, in a very male, you know, industry too, that to me, there's no difference. And I think that there's nothing better that I've seen a great balance when there's a man and a woman thinking alike to help each other, not against each other, to help each other.
Absolutely.
Because again, we have a different perspective, men too.
Right.
We combine both together. We can make so much out of it instead of just.
We're so much stronger together, truly.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
And it's a shame. I really see the fact that we're still going through this process. It really is. Now, you know, it's 2019, my goodness.
Right.
I mean, when are we changing this? But you're saying that we're only sure by one state, is that right?
So one state, or at least the legal part of it, that we have protection, which is very important, because, you know, we will hopefully be able to call out bad behaviors and actually not be dismissed. The other piece that's really important to note for women is that in terms of leadership in a corporation, to be able to shatter your glass ceiling, whatever, if it's your own personal glass ceiling, if you have an idea of where you want to be in that company, or it's the glass ceiling of the company, the CEO or whatever position, boardrooms have a big play in this. So there have been studies that have showed that if women have 30% plus representation in the boardroom, that's when they finally get listened to a voice that isn't the token woman. And so from 30% onward, and 40% is really the tipping point where women have now equity and can rise in the ranks. And Norway is one of the countries that have actually passed a law that any company that is publicly traded have to have 40% women on the board.
Excellent.
And their country have the most women CEOs of traded companies than other countries. So we know that that's a statistical fact.
That's incredible. I love it. And again, it's not, you know, by all means that we're putting men down. It's just the fact that I think it's so important for them to hear this kind of subject. It really is. Because luckily, they don't have to go through it. We do.
Right.
You know, that's sort of like someone telling you you're handicapped when you're not.
Right.
You know, it's like saying, okay, here's the ladder of, you know, of a career, and this is how far you can go. And once you reach that step, look down, don't look up.
And incredibly, even in professions that are more women-based, teachers and nurses as examples, where the percentage of women are 80% or more, there's still a higher percentage of leadership by men in those professions, even though the majority of the profession is made out of women. So again, we're still seeing that inequity of leadership positions where men still have the upper hold, even though they're a minority within that group.
Wow, that makes you wonder, huh?
Right? Really? Isn't that incredible?
It does. Because you're right, registered nurse, it's more female kind of feel, more than
80%.
80%, that's how high it is. And then, but look at your position. I mean, as doctors, we always saw more male doctors than we saw females. And I have to say that in the last maybe 2 years, I've seen a lot more female doctors graduating. Right.
And yet, despite that, we still have lower pay. We still, in the academic positions at universities,
right.
Women are still harassed with lower pay. And they are not put in leadership positions. So we have still inequity across the board, even in those situations.
That is very, very sad to hear that. It really is. Again, I've been out of the corporate world for quite a few years now. And well, I set my own rules.
That's a great thing. That's the best.
It is, indeed it is. But I will tell you that sometimes, and I will share this too, most of my clients are male, okay? And I have had somewhere I pretty much ended the relationship because for some reason in their mindset, they had that invaded where they felt that, well, okay, you're here and you're independent, but I'm still a man.
Right.
And I can push it down.
Right.
No. No, right. You cannot do that because I'm not gonna allow you to do that to me.
Right.
You might do it to other women, but not to me.
Right.
And I think it's all about respect, really.
Totally about respect.
Please. You know, you want to be respected, you need to give respect.
Right. Exactly.
It's not about imposing, you know, and making you know, say, well, I'm just because of my gender, you have to listen to me, you have to follow my rules. And again, going back to what I feel like it's been such a perfect combination, you know, when we have a man and a woman coming together with good intent to help each other, to create something wonderful, the results of it is so beautiful. It really is. So sometimes I cannot, possibly my mind cannot comprehend why would there still be these kind of discriminations where in pay, why? If we graduated with the same degree, if we have the same years of experience,
we
pay our dues like you did as a man. Why is it just because my gender is different, I have to get a cut in my paycheck? It just tells me that men have to get paid more no matter what, even if you have less experience. I've seen those cases coming into companies where I have noticed that maybe, you know, a CEO from a company with the same title was making, like you said, 20-30% more. And if that position got terminated or, you know, they resigned, they got a female in this case, which was great. But guess what? It was not the same pay. Not the same pay. And when I have questioned that to the business owners, being men, they say, well, you know, she's a female.
Really? What an great excuse.
Well, and they're like, well, it's normal. It's normal.
Yeah.
That's their answer. It's normal men get paid more. I said, no, it's not normal. I said, now I understand if you would say to me that that female has half the years of experience of your last CEO who was a male. Or maybe has a less degree, instead of having a master, maybe has a bachelor's. If you want to make it comparable, you know, you can't compare apples and apples when it doesn't exist.
Right.
So that is concerning to me, and I hope that with this movement and everything else, that really, I mean, something changes in our
future. I hope so too.
I'm very happy to hear it, and I'll definitely something that we need to share it, you know, across all social media. And you know, and by all means, again, you know, send me a link from it, the hashtag and everything. I'd be happy to share it. Yeah. I think it's important. And again, for men who are listening, watching this webcast, support us, please do.
Right, absolutely.
Because you came from a woman. I mean, that's what it comes down to. And you know, you have females around you. So right. What better than to support the same way as we look at the discrimination with the LGBT, right? And the gay movements and everything, just because you have a preference doesn't make you should get paid less.
That's right. Exactly. It makes no sense. Same as the color of your skin, which is nothing to do with intelligence at all. It's simply a melanin cells that are higher in darker skin people. I mean, it's a biological, that's it. There's nothing different about us, you know?
I believe that the word discrimination should be completely, you know, deleted from the dictionary.
Absolutely.
I mean, where
in the perfect world.
In the perfect world, but, you know, where we eliminate the discriminations, whether you're female, whether you're a color person.
Right.
Age. Whether you're nationality, whether you have an accent, and then I don't think I should pay you. Or whatever might be that humans come up with excuses.
Right, exactly.
And they're entitled to discriminate others, which is so sad.
Right.
Because I think that one of the things we need to look at is ourselves in the mirror.
Right.
And say, who am I?
Right.
Criticize others.
Right.
And I think that's really, you know, the main message here is
right.
That we need, you know, everyone's support, including all of you, my men audience, please support us. Again, you have females around you, whether it's family or friends, you know, because your support really helps us a lot to make this successful and to really make positive changes for all of us. That's
right.
What it comes down to. So once again, Doctor, how can the audience reach out to you, your books? I know you have quite a few, and I love women to reach out to you and see how much information they can get, please.
Yeah, so I have a website, www.Christina, without an H, C-R-I-S-T-I-N-A, Perelman, P-E-R-E-L-M-A-N, .com.
Okay.
Right. And then you can find my books on Amazon. They're all on Amazon. My very first book talks about women in developed and underdeveloped countries and the role of religion and the role of corporate America, medicine, talks about everything we were talking about today. And it's told a little more whimsically through fairy tales, the attributes. So it's a funner book. But my latest book is really meant to, it's a short, sweet book that has worksheets that women can really use.
Good.
And they're working, they're busy, they don't have time to read 300, 400, 500 pages. It's a quick book that has a lot of helpful tips on how to empower themselves and what to look for in companies. And that one's called The New Working Woman's Revolution. And that's on Amazon also. And so you can either find it through my website or my author site on Amazon. So it's amazon.com/author/CC Perelman, MD. MD at the end.
Excellent. That is excellent. Yes. And I know one of the phrases that I like about your, on one of your paragraphs that you had on your side was, equity is still just a concept, not a reality.
Right. Unfortunately, it is.
So I kind of wanted to end up with that because I think that's really important for people to kind of hear that, that we need to make it into a reality.
Right, absolutely.
Just the right thing to do.
Right.
And again, it's about, you know what, being equal to all. And like I said, no age, no religion. That's another great topic.
Right.
Something that
right.
We can discuss
absolutely.
On this location. Because as we know, all the way from even Catholics all the way to, you know, Jewish, I mean, there have been Muslims. I have had the opportunity to travel in among many countries, along with Turkey, and being in the Blue Mosque, right, one of the big religious sites, which yes. is unbelievable, by the way. I could feel as a I call it as a freedom woman that I am. I could feel the eyes of men looking at me. Just because I was there, like I didn't deserve to be in a holy place, to pray as they pray. And again, I am Christian, and I was still there because I still believe in the same God, right? So that's the concept, and I think that's something that is important for people to understand also, that we have religion discrimination too. It's just a pity. It really is. That's my conclusion, and hopefully we are going to make changes, because we need to do it for the future of a woman. And definitely, whatever I can, I will. That's the way I look at it. So, I want to thank you so much for spending, this time with us, and I wish you a lot of success. And
thank you. Folks.
And who knows, maybe you could come up with, do you have a YouTube channel or?
I do. And I don't have the link to it, I'm sorry, but I do have a YouTube channel.
But you can look it up with your name, I'm sure.
Yes, correct.
Okay, excellent, yeah. And I think that, for me, it's about the value that we bring. That's what it comes down to. Not a gender, not a color, not an age.
Right.
The true value, and that we should all be...
as a human, right.
Human, be treated equally. So I hope that's profound words for everyone out there. The better we get along, the better results we're going to all get. We're going to enjoy
Absolutely.
At the end, So thank you, Doctor, for making time to be with us. And I hope we stay in touch and continue doing all those positive changes.
Right.
So many women out there. I think we were some of the ones in the movement that we can really try our best to push forward and help every other woman out there. So.
Right.
To all my dear audience, all the men out there, remember, please, supporters, I'm asking you for it. For the women, of course, be their supporters, and let's make this happen. And again, let's make a movement for the next, 50 years, that hopefully other women won't have to go through this, and this would just be part of the history.
That's right. Right.
So amen to that. Thank you, Doctor, once
Thank
again
you.
For your time. And
my
I wish
pleasure.
You all success. And like I said, we will stay in touch. So to all my dear audience, thank you, like, share, and comment. You have any questions, as always, on the YouTube channel, you have a comment box. You can put those questions, or you can always reach out to the doctor and send her any questions directly if you have. And like I said, stay in touch. And into the next episode, thank you for taking the time to, watching or listening to a podcast. And until next episode, wish you a lot of success. Liz Soria, your host of the Tax Advisor Business Success Podcast. Take care. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.